Nero fixed the political rift sowed by Claudius and adjudicated by the advice of great men and Agrippina. He soon discarded them and ruled more akin to Caligula than Augustus. Lucius Domitius Ahenobarbus was born in Antium on December 15, 37 AD. His father swiftly died and his mother was exiled, but he was reunited with Agrippina come the reign of Claudius, whom she killed to get Nero on the throne. Nero, not yet 17, was assured a smooth succession thanks to Agrippina, who now essentially ruled Rome on his behalf, alongside the philosopher Seneca and the Praetorian prefect Burrus. A little golden age was ushered in, and Nero was content to simply pursue his passions, until 59 AD, when he decided to kill his burdensome mother. Burrus died soon after, and Seneca decided to bail. Liberated from his advisors, Nero was free to divorce his wife, Octavia, and marry a slave girl, Poppaea Sabina, who died 3 years later. Devastated, but not defeated, Nero found himself a slave boy, Sporus, who resembled Poppaea so much that he had him castrated and considered him Sabina reborn. The Great Fire of Rome struck in 64 AD, destroying much of the city. Nero used the convenient opportunity to rebuild Rome to his Greek tastes. Additionally, he sectioned off one-third of the land to build a personal palace. Attempting to ease the new economic strain, he hiked taxes, then left to become an Olympic athlete. The revolt of Vindex, and more importantly Galba, the governor of Spain, spelt Nero's downfall. Abandoned by his Praetorians, he killed himself after receiving a melodramatic message claiming the Senate ordered his execution. He bled out on June 9th, 68 AD, heirless, and the last of the Julio-Claudians. The circumstances led to Imperator Galba and the Year of the Four Emperors.